Canis Major, and Canis Minor.
Welcome to Stargazers. I'm Dean Regas, astronomer from the Cincinnati Observatory.
And I'm James Albury, director of the Kika Silva Plaw Planetarium in Gainesville, Florida. Dean and I often talk about Orion the Hunter, but rarely do we ever get to talk about his two dogs, Canis Major and Canis Minor.
That's right, James. After Orion was stung by Scorpius the Scorpion, he was placed in the sky. However, like most dog lovers, Orion was lonely without his beloved hunting dogs. So Zeus placed his dogs in the sky to keep him company. Let's show you.
Okay, we have our skies set up for about an hour after sunset any night this week, facing south. High in the sky, you'll see the familiar stars of Orion the Hunter. The three stars forming his belt make him easy to find.
To find Canis Major, use Orion's belt and start with the star on the far right. That star is Mintaka. Then draw a line from Mintaka through Alnilam and Alnitak and keep going. And you'll run smack dab into the brightest star in the night sky. That star's name is Sirius.
Sirius is the brightest star in the night sky because it's relatively close to us. At roughly 8 light-years away, Sirius definitely makes its presence known. You can often see Sirius twinkling brilliantly in the southern sky.
The name Sirius comes from the Greek word for scorching, and it's actually a binary star system. The companion star, Sirius B, is a white dwarf with an orbital period of almost 50 years. Sirius A and Sirius B had their smallest angular separation from each other back in 1993. The greatest angular separation will happen between 2020 and 2025.
Now for the other stars in Canis Major. Up and to the left of Sirius, we have Mulefane, a blue-white giant star 441 light-years from Earth. And on the other side of Sirius, we have Mirzam. Mirzam is 500 light-years away, and its name means the announcer, because from most locations, it rises just a few minutes before Sirius.
Just to the south and east of Sirius, you'll see a small triangle of stars which mark the hindquarters of Canis Major. The star at the top of the triangle is named Weizen, a yellow-white supergiant about 1,600 light-years from us.
This star's name means the weight, and for good reason. Weizen is massive. It's 17 times the mass of our sun, over 50,000 times as bright, and its diameter is the same as the orbit of the Earth. Therefore, if it took the place of the sun in our solar system, we would be skimming across its surface.
Just to the left of Weizen, we have the star Aludra. Aludra is even brighter than Weizen, but only half its diameter. Aludra is a blue-white supergiant shining over 176,000 times as bright as our sun and is a whopping 2,000 light-years away.
The other star in the triangle is Adhara. Today, Adhara is 430 light-years away, but almost 5 million years ago, Adhara was close enough to the Earth to be the brightest star in the night sky, dramatically outshining Sirius and even rivaling the brilliance of the planet Venus.
All right, let's now talk about Orion's other hunting dog, Canis Minor.
This should be easy. Canis Minor only has two stars.
Well, two that you can see from most major cities. Believe it or not, this tiny constellation has over 50 stars.
No way.
Yes way. Now, granted, many of those stars are dimmer than fourth magnitude. Nevertheless, they're up there.
To find Canis Minor, take Orion's shoulder stars, Bellatrix and Betelgeuse, and draw a line toward the east, and you'll run into the two stars, Procyon and Gomisa. Procyon is the brighter of the two and is only 11 light years from us.
Gomisa is 162 light-years away and is 195 times as bright as our sun, with a surface temperature of over 20,000 degrees Fahrenheit.
Wow, 20,000 degrees. I guess you could say Canis Minor is a really hot dog.
Anyway, get outside tonight and check out Orion's two hunting dogs and all their celestial splendor.
It's easy to do when you keep looking up.